therefore appeal to the parents to take their children back to school as a matter of urgency. I know some may not have provided the scholastic materials, but as long as you can provide books and pens, let these children report at school.
And the fees that was there before even COVID-19 should remain. They should not add on more. So it is our appeal that parents take back pupils to school, because education is key in this country. If you have a community that is not educated, it is disastrous.
Stella Chorampe, the Kabarak District Vice Chairperson, says that youth of school-going age in the district have resorted to petty jobs such as hawking, cattle grazing, stone quarrying and sand mining, while some young girls have been taken up as bartenders and housemaids within Kabarak District and beyond.
I've gone to seek for labor, house girls, shamba boys, huds boys, just to make sure to make ends meet. Then now, we as the parents, we need to know that education is very important. And as leaders, we need to continue mobilizing. The situation is alarming, things are expensive, but we have to work.
So these are parents, their students, all their children, they are on private schools. Private schools, they have increased school fees amounts into a high amounts that we had never expected that. So we have so that's why you see most students are still at home. So me as a leader, I'm encouraging parents honestly to take their school, to use government aided schools.
Kwekiriza Edinali, the district youth counselor, says that bad peer groups have also influenced some learners not to go back to school.
If students not returning back to school, it has been caused by a number of issues, but mostly some students they intend not to go back to school just because of peer groups, of which we as leaders we have intervened to come and talk to them. But as leaders, it is not enough. We also call upon the parents to come out and speak out with their children to show them the importance of education.
Victoria Rusoke, the Kabarak District Woman Member of Parliament and Local Government Minister, has donated over 600 reusable sanitary pads to school-going youth in Kabarak District. Minister Rusoke says that this is part of her efforts to encourage young girls to stay in school and complete studies.
Female delegates of Reproductive Health Uganda, branch, join hands with the good youth I see here, strong and dynamic, to fight one of the causes of girls drop out of school. We want our girls to recruit in school, stay in school, and complete school.
This report was compiled by Roger Sunday for the news.